So here on the Hinkley Point C, a nuclear new build project, Balfour Beatty are here appointed to construct part of the water cooling system. Here at Avonmouth, we've constructed 6 reinforced concrete heads, 4 intake heads and 2 outfall heads. These heads then are connected to tunnels which are being built in the Bristol Channel, and those tunnels then supply and take water from the nuclear power plant to then provide the cooling system. Each intake head structure is just under 5,000 tonne in total weight. Each is constructed of about 10 individual pours and built up to its total height of just under 10 metres. Lengthwise, it's 45 metres, nosing to nosing, and widthwise, just over 16 metres. The actual load out of the intake heads was planned and thought about well before even the first bit of concrete or rebar went down for the heads. So they were constructed on temporary stools, which were at the correct height to allow for the SVMTs that you see behind me here to be able to go underneath, hydrology jack up the head, and then travel towards the key edge that you see behind me. From there, it's loaded onto 2 different barges, first being the transfer barge and the second being the transport barge. So the most critical part for the intake head is the length of the head, and well, there's stages where it's partly on the ro-ro ramps, partly on the transfer barge and partly on the transport barge. The key part and biggest challenge of this operation is ensuring that the barges stay level with the quay, and that's done through a series of complicated ballast operations where the water's pumped out the barges as the weight's added to the barges and transferred on. For one intake head, it takes approximately 6 to 7 hours to travel the last 150 metres into its set down position. It's then transferred over to another quay where it's then fitted out, ready for sail away effectively. So sea fastening works are undertaken and all the installation of the intake heads equipment is put onto the barge. That takes approximately 2 weeks. After that, it's then sailed out into the Bristol Channel to the installation site where it's placed onto the seabed.